The Faculty of Engineering of the University of Peradeniya is 69 years old. During this period, many have contributed in different ways to make this institution what it is today. Among them, Helarisi Abeyruwan has been a quiet and steady contributor. Helarisi's association with this faculty spans 46 years. First four as an undergraduate student, the rest as a member of the academic staff of the Department of Civil Engineering. As the only child of Mr. Jayasekhar Abeyruwan and Mrs. Samyavati Rajapaksha, Helarisi enjoyed a gilded life as a child. He started schooling at the Sri Bodhi Vidyalay in Gampaha. He fondly remembers that his mother was his first teacher at this school. 3 years later, he was admitted to a leading Buddhist school in Colombo, Nalanda College. Upon completion of secondary education at Nalanda, young Helarisi entered the Faculty of Engineering at Peradeniya in 1973. This was the beginning of his 46-year-long association with this great institution. Structural designs and concrete technology have been his specializations. This became his lifelong passion. Upon graduation in 1977, Helarisi was recruited to the academic staff of the Department of Civil Engineering. He has remained as a member of this department ever since. It was in 1980 that Helarisi got married to Samudu Gunasekara. Within a short time of his joining the academic staff of the faculty, Helarisi was awarded a Commonwealth Scholarship at the University of Hong Kong.
I met Helarisi for the first time in 1975, 44 years back. At the time, he was wearing white and white. We all know that he is the best concrete man in the country. But very much more than that, he is a person who will listen to others. Helarisi had a vast knowledge in subjects like medicine, politics, social studies, and also human qualities. So because of that, many of us in the faculty continue to go to him, as he was the most dependable person I could think of for advice at the faculty.
Helarisi is an empathic academic. He always connected with students freely, listened to their concerns. He could easily interact with students and staff. His room was always open to them.
So talking about Mr. Abeyruwan, he was one of the faculty who was very approachable. So we could easily talk to him about any problems we had with the class material.
Helarisi made very significant contributions to the development of our academic programs. He was always aware of the most current developments in the field of civil engineering. He made very important contributions in the development of academic programs in the areas of his specialty, which was structural designs and concrete technology. For example, he took the leadership in getting our department to introduce the recently adopted Euro codes for structural designs in the teaching program. Our department was the first department in the country to do so.
In addition to his academic activities, Helarisi offered his wholehearted cooperation in administrative affairs as well. He served as a lecturer in charge of the materials testing laboratory for many years. He also served as the head of the Department of Civil Engineering for 3 years. Leading by example was Helarisi's style. He continually upgraded the quality and the standards of the facilities in the materials testing laboratory. With the help of the faculty workshop, he managed to develop and fabricate in-house many important laboratory equipment. As a participating member of the American Society for Testing and Materials, commonly known as ASTM, he was able to keep up with the relevant developments and ensure that the work in the laboratory was in line with the latest advances. Enhancement and development of strong industry relations was another area that Helarisi cultivated. One aspect of this was enhancing and expanding the range of laboratory testing services available to the industry. This was beneficial to the industry as well as to the faculty.
First, I would like to talk about the honorary consultancies we did together, for which we did not get any payment. We first worked on the conservation and restoration of Jethavana Stupa in Anuradhapura, and then later Abhayagiri Stupa. I did the analysis using the finite element method to find out the stresses within the stupa, and Mr. Abeyruwan designed the tensile reinforcement necessary to take up tension in the tensile regions in the stupa. One of the main consultancies is the design checking of the Bank of Ceylon Tower, which is in Colombo Fort.
During his long association with the faculty, Helarisi made substantial contributions to the development of its infrastructure too. Many of the buildings constructed during this period benefited from his expertise. In all these activities, he had a secret source of inspiration and encouragement, the wholehearted support he received from his loving family, spouse Samudu and daughter Oshadi. At the end of this year, Helarisi will bid farewell to his beloved faculty. He will retire from his lifelong career at the University of Peradeniya. But his contributions to this institution will live on. They will continue to benefit not only the present students, but also many generations of future students yet to embark on their own journeys at the Peradeniya Engineering Faculty.